We continue with our next speaker. I want to introduce you André van Steitegem. I hope I pronounce your name well, because I'm only Dutch, so I don't know. He's a professor emeritus at the Free University of Brussels, and he was a chairman there of the medical board, a dean and a vice rector. Being a medical scientist, Professor van Steitegem published mainly in the field of reproductive medicine, if I'm correct. As of October last year, you are, I understood, the chair of the Flemish Committee of Scientific Integrity. And this committee can give, for instance, a second opinion in cases of possible scientific fraud. We would very much like to hear about the works of this committee and some examples, maybe. Thank you.
Thank you very much, and thank you for the opportunity that's given to me to talk about the newly founded Flemish Commission of Research Integrity. Okay, first, I have no competing interest to declare, but during several decades, I was a mentor of research, an author, a reviewer, an associate editor for several journals. And then when I became emeritus, I became editor of Human Reproduction. And since the beginning, I also joined the Committee on Publication Ethics, COPE. And by now, I am the secretary of COPE now. And then since October 2013, I became the chair of the Flemish Commission, I said Belgium, but it's the Flemish Commission of Research Integrity. Okay, what was the situation in Flanders prior to the VCWI? I think each Flemish university had his own committee on scientific integrity, and I call it here with a legal term sui generis. I mean, it's a bit different from one university to the others. And I don't know exactly where we are now, and I'm looking forward to what our colleagues from the Committees of Scientific Integrity will tell us later this morning. And in fact, the VCWI was an initiative of the board of the Fund for Scientific Research Flanders, FWO, and the board of that FWO is in fact directors of the universities. And so they set up a task force in 2011 to set up the Flemish Council of Research Integrity. And then in the period 2012-2013, the rules, the bylaws of the commission were approved by the founding members, and then afterwards the members of the committee were elected, and we started the commission on 7 October 2013. So it's a very new commission. The founding members are the two academies, the Koninklijke Vlaamse Academie van België voor Kunst, voor Wetenschappen en Kunsten, and also the Medical Academy. Then we already, two of the main funders of research, the FWO, Fund for Scientific Research Flanders, and then the IWT, dus Wetenschap en Technologie, and then the five Flemish universities, the KU Leuven, Universiteit Antwerpen, Universiteit Gent, Universiteit Hasselt, and the Vrije Universiteit Brussel. What are the aims? What is the background why the VCWI was set up? It's to come to a better harmonization of research integrity handling in Flanders. And, of course, and we will talk a little bit more about that, the possibility of a second advice of cases of research integrity infringements which had already been dealt by the institutions. Eventually, we could work all together to a better deontological code. And I think a very important issue is that, in general, the VCWI could increase the sensibility of the issues over the board as well. And I think this is quite important. So we had the founding members. And another thing is that the VCWI is, in fact, I don't think, no, remember the exact term in the bylaws, but it's located at the Academy of Arts and Sciences. And we have some secretarial support from the Academy, and we usually come together at in the buildings of it, the Palace of Academies, not so far from here. And so there are two tasks, and that's clearly in the bylaws: advice on general matters and a second opinion on cases. So I will show you in a moment the website, but the basic documents that are also applicable to the commission are listed here. And so there was already in 2009 at the initiative of all academies and of the Federal Committee on Science Policy, there was an ethical code for scientific research in Belgium. And then you have different codes from the EC, 2005. An important one is the European Science Foundation and ALEA, European Conduct of Code of Conduct for Research Integrity from 2011. And then you have also the statements made at the World Congress on Research Integrity, as well the one in Singapore, and last, 2013, May, I think, was the one in Montreal. And I think in 2015 or 16, there is one in Brazil, which is already planned by now. And especially in Montreal, I think the focus was on internationalization of handling of research integrity. And I think the statements which came out of these different world congresses are extremely useful. So we have bylaws. And the bylaws talk about the composition and the election of members. What is the task? What is the advice related to breaches of research integrity, the procedure? And then there is also a surveillance committee, which in Dutch is het comité van toezicht, surveillance committee. I'll talk a little bit about that. So we have a website, www.vcwi.be. It's almost there. You still are sent to the website of the Academy, but everything is there, and I think there is a lot of useful information already on the website. So the composition of the committee is, there are 9 members, and one of them is the chair. I happen to be the chair. And there are, for each of the 3 domains, basic and applied sciences, biomedical science, humanities, and social sciences, there are 3 members for each of these domains, which means 9 members of the commission. There is one legal expert added to the commission without voting power, and also a secretary, which is, I'll talk about that a little later, no voting power, but of course extremely important in this. And we are elected for 4 years, and the mandate can be renewed once. The members of the committee and the chairman are assigned by a comité van toezicht. And the committee, as I said already, is located in the Academy which provides secretarial assistance. We are fortunate that the next speaker, Olivier Böhm, which is working at the Fund for Scientific Research Flanders and who was involved from the beginning in the task force and in setting it up, has agreed to be acting secretary of the VCWI for the time being. All members of the committee are from one of the Flemish universities. Per domain, there can only be one member of the same university and only one emeritus per domain. I think now there are two emeritus, or almost three. We have the legal expert, who is also an emeritus, and myself. The members need to have at least the rank of professor, and there is, which is normal, I think, an incompatibility with the membership of the Research Integrity Council of the university. This is also in our bylaws mentioned. What are the tasks? There are two types of tasks. There is a general advisory role. So scientific institutions in Flanders can ask advice of the committee on general questions related to research integrity. And also the committee can start working on this type of advice as well. And then the second opinion, I think it's clear, and this is crystal clear in the bylaws, possible research misconduct cases are examined by the Commission of Research Integrity of the universities or the institutions working on that, and the conclusions of handling this research misconduct case is notified for a decision to the board of the university or the scientific. A second opinion can be asked to the committee by the university prior to the decision of the case, or by an individual prior to or after the decision has been made. Advice on cases, and all of this is very clearly explained. A file to the committee can only be submitted if already examined by the Research Integrity Commission of the university or institution, and the institution or the individual asks a second advice. The committee is only dealing or giving advice on content and procedure, not at all or possible disciplinary actions that will result of it. And all of those who agreed, the founding members of the committee, agreed to take into account the advice of the VCWI procedure. So a possible case is sent to the secretary, and again, this is clearly indicated. And within 7 days, secretary and chair discuss whether we have to go further with this. Then the chair consults the members, and within 3 weeks, the applicant must be informed whether the case is acceptable for advice. And then we have 6 months, to maximum 6 months, to come to formulate an advice. We aim at consensus in the committee. If it is not possible, then there is a majority advice that's possible. Of course, competing interest in submitted case must be read out, and there is a strict confidentiality from all committee members, experts, and possible witnesses. And also, I think the institution need to assure confidentiality by the personnel dealing with the case. Communication between the committee and those involved is under the responsibility of the chair. Then we have a surveillance committee. We have to report as committee at least once a year the annual report to tell what we have done in the past year. And they are also the ones committee of surveillance. There is a representative of the 9 founding members, and they nominate, as I mentioned already, the members of the committee, including the chair. Shortly after the committee was started, the Minister of Scientific Policy, Mrs. Litten, asked the Strategic Research Center to adhere to the committee, which has been done so far. And so VIB, EMEC, iMinds have agreed to be part of VCWI, and other institutions have showed interest, Tropical Institute, ILVO, and VITO. So we are a young committee. We have no cases submitted yet. It's work in progress. We became last month or 2 months ago the member of the European Network of Research Integrity Offices, and we are in close contact with our Dutch colleagues of the Landelijk Orgaan voor Wetenschappelijke Integriteit, which have, of course, already in existence of 10 years. Thanks for the attention, and of course, I will be happy to take questions later. Thank you.